Good evening and welcome, Rhema South Coast Family Church, to our online Bible study and Holy Communion. I'm so glad that you have joined us today and hope that this time makes a positive, life-changing impact in your life. Before we get started, let us spend a moment in worship to our Lord. The topic I would like to speak to today is titled, I Can't Come Down. I want to read something profound that I heard yesterday whilst listening to a podcast, one of my favorite podcasts. And the speaker said the following quote, don't trade your ultimate for an immediate. In other words, don't trade what God ultimately has in store for you, his purpose, his plans, for an immediate want or distraction. He goes on to say that we need to know that every decision that we make will result in the story that we tell or the story that is told about us. So today there are many voices, distractions that we all face. Certain unnecessary tasks, projects, gadgets, TV programs, sport in my case, that is screaming for our attention. There's so much noise out there that can so easily keep us busy and get in the way of the important things in life. Some might seem urgent, but we really need to ask the questions, are they really that urgent? Is it worth me stopping what God has in store for me to do this something else? That is what I'm talking about today. For some of us, we might be so busy that we are missing out on what's important in life. We cannot lose focus. The question I want to ask you today is, what is in the way or keeps getting in the way of living out God's purpose for your life? For some of you, it might be an addiction, a hobby, being in a relationship with the wrong person, being friends with the wrong people. How many of you are sacrificing the ultimate plan that God has for you for an immediate nicety? I would like to read the story about Nehemiah. And in the book of Nehemiah, we see the walls of Jerusalem that are down, the gates are burnt, and Nehemiah sees God's plan for him to go and build these walls, fix the gates, so that God's people can be protected and the temple be protected. And Nehemiah leaves Persia to go and fix the walls. That's his plan that God has for him, his purpose for his life. And while building, many neighboring towns saw this as a threat. And we pick up the story while Nehemiah is physically on the wall building. And it says in Nehemiah 6, verse 1 to 9, when Sanballat and Tobiah and Geshem the Arab and the rest of our enemies heard that I had rebuilt the wall and that there were no more breaks in it, even though I hadn't yet installed the gates, Sanballat and Geshem sent the message, come and meet us at Kephrim in the valley of Ono. I knew they were scheming to hurt me, so I sent messengers back with this. I am doing a great work. I can't come down. Why should the work come to a standstill just so that I can come down and see you? Four times they sent this message, and four times I gave my answer. The fifth time, the same messenger, same message, Sanballat sent an unsealed letter with this message. The word is out among the nations, and Geshem, say it's true, that you and the Jews are planning to rebel. This is why you are rebuilding the wall. The word is just that you want to be king and that you have appointed prophets to announce in Jerusalem. There's a king in Judah. The king is going to be told all this. Don't you think we should sit down and have a talk? I sent him back this. There's nothing what you are saying. You've made it all up. They were trying to intimidate us into quitting. They thought they'll give up. They'll never finish it. I prayed, give me strength. Family, just like Nehemiah, while you are busy with God's plans and purpose for your life, don't allow the enemy to come in and distract you. Don't allow distractions to get in the way of the purpose that God has for you. It's very important to realize these distractions when they come in and put them in its rightful place. Distractions can be dangerous. They can steal your purpose, and we can't lose focus. This year is going to be a great year. God has great plans for his people. God has great plans for you, and we can't afford to lose focus. Focus, just like Pastor Larry spoke the other week, He had a picture of hands up with a clear vision with a blurry background. And it's so important for us to know, just like Proverbs 29 verse 18 says, where there is no vision, a clear revelation of who God is in your life, the people will wander astray. It's very important for us to know that we cannot lose focus. We cannot lose out for the vision that God has for us. Amen? So don't be led astray by distractions. Keep your vision clearly focused and fixed on God's plans and purpose for your life. Allow God to speak to you in 2023 and show you His plans for you so that you may make wise choices, decisions to not distract you from His plan. Amen? As we get ready to take communion, it's very important for us to know that communion is a powerful way for us to celebrate this intimate connection we have, our ongoing relationship with Jesus. Let us partake together tonight. Allow God to build and strengthen our relationship with Him as we celebrate our communion. It says in 1 Corinthians, "For I receive from the Lord, which I also deliver to you, that the Lord Jesus, in the night in which He was betrayed, He took bread, and when He had given thanks, He broke it and said, 'This is my body, which is for you, which is for us. Do this in remembrance of me.'" Amen. It says in 1 Corinthians 11:25 that in the same way, He took the cup also after supper, saying, "This is the cup as the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until He comes." Amen. Family, thank you for spending this evening with us. I'm so glad that you logged on. Please don't forget to meet us in person every Sunday at 8 a.m. and 10 a.m. Also, if you would like to join us online, please connect with us at 8 a.m. for our premier service online. And thank you for joining us, and see you soon.